of you. This is Shankar Reddy, lecturer in political science from Government Junior College for Girls, Maritpally, Secunderabad. Before going to start second year civics or political science, we should know about role of the second year syllabus in various competitive examinations. Our second year syllabus, nothing but the Constitution of India or Indian polity, played crucial role in all the competitive examinations such as attended to IAS. That's why I'm trying to provide basic concepts as well as factual information here. Please try to understand and concentrate on these videos. Watch till the end. Today we are going to start first unit of the second year civics, that is Indian Constitution historical context. You know very well, the Constitution of India is one of the best and the prominent constitution among all the world constitutions. It has a long historical background because the Constitution of India is not developed in a single day. For making our constitution, we made struggle a lot in the period of Indian National Movement. So the development of the Constitution of India laid foundation in the period of Indian National Movement. That's why before going to know about the Constitution of India, we must study about Indian National Movement. You know very well, Britishers came to India for the purpose of trade in the year 1600, December 31st. They established the East India Company for the purpose of trade, and gradually they occupied most of the Indian land from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, and they established their administration in India. They ruled around 200 years in India. Here, against the British colonial rule or cruel rule, Indians made struggle for freedom in different forms. This entire struggle for freedom is known as Indian National Movement. Here, how the Indian National Movement is originated, what are the reasons behind that, let us try to understand with the causes for the birth of Indian National Movement. Before going to start causes for the birth of Indian National Movement, let us try to understand small introduction about Indian National Movement. Indian National Movement organized between the period of 1857 to 1947. What is the importance of 1857 and what is the importance of 1947? Let us try to understand. In the year 1857, first time the Indians fought revolt against the Britishers. It is the first attempt from the Indian side against the British colonial rule. In Indian history, it made create lots of history. That's why we considered first attempt in Indian National Movement is 1857 Great Revolt against the British colonial rule. So whereas most of the historians are not accepted, 1857 is the initial incident of the Indian history, because the 1857 Great Revolt or Sipahi Mutiny are nothing but the first war of Indian independence is not considered as the starting point of the Indian National Movement because of it does not have common leadership, and also most of the Indians are not involved in this agitation, in this movement, and also it was not spreaded throughout the country. So it was limited some part of the country. That's why historians, most of the historians, nothing but the R.C. Majumdar, not accepted 1857 is the initial point of the Indian National Movement. Then what is the initial point of the Indian National Movement officially? A establishment of Indian National Congress in the year 1885. According to the R.C. Majumdar, what is the official period of the Indian National Movement is 1885 to 1947. 1885 is the establishment of Indian National Congress till the end 1947. That was India attainment of independence. That means between the establishment of Indian National Congress and the India attainment of independence, the entire period is considered as Indian National Movement. This statement was supported by Dr. Pattabhi Sitaramaya's statement. So Dr. Pattabhi Sitaramaya is the former president of Indian National Congress. He mentioned clearly about the importance of Indian National Congress in his famous book History of Indian National Congress. In this, he clearly mentioned the history of Indian National Congress is really the history of India's struggle for freedom. The history of Indian National Congress is really the history of India's struggle for freedom. So what it means? So here the history of Indian National Congress is nothing but the history of India's struggle for freedom. That means there is no differences between Indian National Congress and the Indian freedom struggle. We are not separated Indian National Congress from the Indian struggle for freedom because of entire the Indian struggle for freedom led by the Indian National Congress from the beginning till the attainment of India's independence. This is the brief introduction about the Indian National Movement. Let us try to understand what are the causes for the birth of Indian National Movement. Here I am providing some of the causes for the birth of Indian National Movement. In examination point of view, if they ask 5 marks, you have to choose any 4 of them, and otherwise if they will ask as 10 marks, then you have to mention all those causes for the birth of Indian National Movement. Let us try to understand what are the causes for the birth of Indian National Movement at a glance. So British colonial rule. The first one is that British colonial rule. And the second one, socio-cultural renaissance. Third one, Great Revolt. And fourth one, English education. Fifth one, economic exploitation. Sixth one, famines and acute poverty. Seventh one, press. Eighth one, repressive rule. Ninth one, racial discrimination. And also some other causes are there for the birth of Indian National Movement. Let us try to understand one by one. The first, so British colonial rule. You know very well, Britishers came to India for the purpose of trade, and also they continued up to India attainment of independence. That means the British colonial rule continued around 200 years in India. In this entire period, the British colonial rule have two impacts on Indian society. One is positive impact, another one is negative impact. So let us try to understand what type of impacts on Indian society during the British colonial rule have one by one. So here let us try to understand first one. First one is that British colonial rule. You know very well, Britishers came to India for the purpose of trade, and gradually they occupied entire India. They introduced their administration in India also. They continued up to India attainment of independence. This entire period undercomes British colonial rule. So around 200 years they continued in India. In this period, British colonial rule have two impacts on Indian society. One is positive impact, another one is negative impact. So positive impact is that they introduced ICS system, Indian Civil Services system. For making the reforms in Indian administrative system, they introduced ICS system, and also they allowed Indians later on in administrative system, nothing but ICS system. At the same time, they introduced judicial system and they reformed judiciary system also. They introduced IPC, CPC, Indian Penal Code, Criminal Procedure Code also they introduced for maintaining law and order. and they also introduced modern means of transport system such as postal, telegraph, telephone, railway system in India. So Indians used these facilities which are provided by the Britishers for communicating from one to another, for mobilizing one area to another area. They made revolt, they made communications against the Britishers with the modern means of transport system. So that's why the people who are used these modern means of transport system, they mobilized people and also they passed their ideas through the postal, telephone, telegraph system and attracted people towards Indian National Movement. Besides this, some negative impacts also there in British colonial rule. What are the negative impacts? Repressive rule. They introduced repressive rule. They followed repressive rule in India and also economic exploitation. These are the negative impacts on India during the British colonial rule. So repressive rule means what? They introduced cruel rules such as Rowlatt Act, Vernacular Press Act. Like this, they introduced cruel policies during the British colonial rule for preventing the revolts against the Britishers. At the same time, they exploited our economic system. You know very well, according to Dadabhai Nowrozi, they drain our economy, they drain our resources to the England. You know, during the British colonial rule, they exported our resources to the England and they manufactured goods in the England companies and they sold goods in our market. So this was happened during the British colonial rule. That's why the people who lost their employment, the people who lost their lives, the people who lost their liberties, they realized and attracted towards Indian National Movement. So this is the British colonial rule. It has two impacts on Indian society, positive impact and negative impact. Both the impacts are inspired the Indians towards attraction of the Indian National Movement. The next cause is that socio-cultural renaissance. Socio-cultural renaissance also played prominent role to promote nationalistic feelings in India. So here, some eminent personalities of the Indian society established some organization for promoting nationalistic feeling, especially for eradicating such a evil practices. So before the entry of the Britishers or during the period of British colonial rule, Indian society faced some evil practices such as sati system and child marriage system, widowed system, old ideal worship system. These are the evil practices which are appeared in Indian society during the British colonial rule. Some eminent personalities come forward and try to eradicate the evil practices in Indian society. They are Raja Ram Mohan Roy, Dayananda Saraswati, Anibi Sen, Swami Vivekananda. Here I am trying to provide small tabular regarding to the information in clear manner. So Raja Ram Mohan Roy established Brahma Samaj in the year 1829. So Raja Ram Mohan Roy established Brahma Samaj. Who established Brahma Samaj? Raja Ram Mohan Roy in the year 1829. And Arya Samaj established by Dayananda Saraswati in the year 1875. Theosophical Society established by Madam Blavatsky, Colonel Olcott in America, whereas in India this was established by Annie Besant. She was the Irish lady. She also launched along with the Balagangadhar Tilak, she also participated, she also organized Home Rule Movement. Later we will discuss. Theosophical Society established in India by Annie Besant, and Ramakrishna Mission established by Swami Vivekananda in the year 1896, 1897. His guru is that Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. His teachings formulated by Swami Vivekananda. His teachings spreaded by Swami Vivekananda throughout the world. You know very well. So these organizations are established by eminent personalities for what? For eradicating the evil practices in India, such as sati, child marriage, widowhood, ideal worship. At the same time, these organizations also promote native education system, women education system, women empowerment also. So by these efforts, Indian society or Indian people realized about their past, realized about their history, and attracted towards self-rule, nothing but the Indian national movement. This is also one of the reason May 10th, one important incident was happened in Indian history. That was Great Revolt. You know very well, Great Revolt also called as Sipahi Mutiny and also called as India's First War of Independence. First War of India's Independence, according to the V.D. Savarkar. Here, what happened in the year 1857? Actually, during the British colonial rule, entire the British army consists two category of soldiers. One is Indian soldier, another one is British soldier. Indian soldiers called as Sipahi. British soldiers called as soldiers. So here there was a lot of differences between Indian Sipahi and British soldiers in the matters of salary, in the matters of treatment, in the matters of using weapons. There was lots of differences. That's why they discriminated. Who discriminated? Indian Sipahis discriminated in the British colonial rule. That's why Mangal Pandey, he is belonging to the 34th Regiment of Bharatpur. He killed his higher officers. Immediately he was hanged over. Then this was the inspiration thing of the entire the Indian Sipahis towards making revolt against Britishers. So that's why Indian Sipahis who are discriminated in the British army, they revolt against the Britishers. This was the first and the foremost movement in Indian history against the British colonial rule. So this movement also supported by native princes. Why they supported? They are suffered under British colonial rule because of the doctrine of lapse. They lost their dynasties, they lost their properties because of doctrine of lapse. What is the doctrine of lapse? Who introduced doctrine of lapse? Doctrine of lapse introduced by Dalhousie, who was the Governor General at the time. According to the doctrine of lapse, the princely kings, then nothing but the native princes who does not have children at the time, their dynasty, their property automatically acquired by Britishers without any war, without any treaty. So that's why by this doctrine of lapse, Jhansi Laxmibai, Nana Saheb, Tantia Tope lost their properties. That's why they are supported to the Sipahis. And they also participated in the Great Revolt. Here, the Sipahi mutiny or Great Revolt is not spreaded throughout the India, and also more the Indian people not involved in this movement. The two community of the people are involved. One is Indian Sipahi, another one is native princes. Here all the native princes also not involved in this movement. Who lost their dynasty, they only involved in this Great Revolt. In Hyderabad point of view, Rohillas and Turabaz Khan led the Great Revolt in Hyderabad. So this Great Revolt is popularly known as First War of India's Independence, according to whom? V.D. Savarkar, Vinayak Damodar Savarkar. And also, after the Great Revolt, Britishers are realized and changed their administrative system. That means there was a lots of changes placed after the Great Revolt. One is very important, that they formulated Government of India Act 1858. By this act, the East India Company of India, the nothing but East India Company, it was established in the year 1600 December 31st. First time it was abolished by the effect of Great Revolt in the year 1858. That means by the Act of Indian Government Act 1858, the East India Company was abolished. That means company rule was abolished in India. Then who ruled in India? Directly they introduced British Queen rule in India. Now who is the Queen of the British India? Then Victoria. Queen Victoria is the Queen of the British India. She directly ruled the India instead of company ruling. So this is the Great Revolt. It is also one inspirational event regarding to the Indian National Movement. So by this inspirational thing, later on so many freedom fighters are involved in the Indian National Movement. Then the next one is that English education. English education also played prominent role in the Indian National Movement. So how the Indian education, how the English education played crucial role in making the Indian nationalistic feelings among the Indians, let us try to understand. Here, before the 1813, Britishers established three educational institutions only in India. They are Kolkata Madrasa, which is established by Warren Hastings in the year 1781. Then second one is that Varanasi Sanskrit Kalasala, which is established by Jonathan Duncan in the year 1791. And also Port William College, which is established by Lord Wellesley for training of the ICS officer at Kolkata in the year 1800. So these are the three educational organizations which are established by Britishers before the 1813. Why we are considered as 1813 as a landmark regarding to the education system in India means, in the year 1813, the Britishers formulated one charter, that was Charter Act 1813. For the first time, by the Act of 1813 Charter Act, they allocated 1 lakh rupee for the education in India. So this is the first incident which are allocated amount to the development of education system in India. Later on, in the year 1835, they introduced English education in India. When was English education were introduced? In the year 1835. So in the year 1835, William Bentinck, he was the Governor General of India at that time, appointed one committee which is headed by Lord Macaulay. That means Lord Macaulay committee appointed by the William Bentinck, Governor General of India at that time, for suggesting introduction of English education. So based on the recommendations of Lord Macaulay committee, William Bentinck introduced English education in the year 1835. At the same time, in the year 1835, English as official language instead of Persian. That means Persian replaced by English as official language in the year 1835. Before the 1835, while Mughals are ruling and the British ruling also, Persian is considered as official language. In the year 1835, Persian was replaced by English as official language. At the same time, they took lots of steps for making the development of education system in India. In the year 1854, they appointed one committee, that was Wood's dispatch. This committee headed by Charles Wood. So this committee recommended establishment of universities in India. According to the Wood's dispatch or Charles Wood's recommendations, Dalhousie, he was the Governor General at the time, introduced or established three universities such as Kolkata University, Bombay University, Madras University. So during the British colonial rule, the education system also developed step by step. That's why the people who joined in English education schools or colleges, they went to England for higher education. At the place of London Library, they observed Hobbes, Rousseau, Locke, J.S. Mill, Bentham writings. They studied properly. At the same time, they realized what is the liberty, what is the equality, justice, how the Britishers enjoyed liberty, how the Indians are not enjoyed the liberty, equality, justice. They realized and compared, and then afterwards they come back to India, they published papers and journals. At the same time, they promoted nationalistic feelings among the Indian society because of the awareness of English education. So this is the impact of the Indian society. English education have lots of impact on Indian society for realizing Indians about the liberty, equality, justice. That's why they are ready to ask about liberty, equality, justice to the Britishers. This is also one of the reason for the development of Indian national movement in India. Then after this, for examination point of view, there was a 5 marks question. That was, explain any 4 causes for the birth of Indian national movement. This was 5 marks question in examination point of view. In this, they mentioned clearly about 4 causes for the birth of Indian national movement. So I suggested first 4 causes for the birth of Indian national movement, while they asked as 5 marks one. You have to choose introduction along with 4 causes for the birth of Indian national movement, such as British colonial rule, at the same time socio-cultural renaissance, great revolt, and English education. You have to write it down. Thank you.